Good afternoon, YouTube. I wanted to show you some of the modifications I've done to my 7x12 horizontal bandsaw that lets me cut angles sharper or more acute than 45 degrees. So right now I'm getting ready to cut a 55 degree angle. A couple of things I've had to do. One is this bolt here. There's normally a pivot bolt here, and then there's a second clamp bolt in this position, but this slot here doesn't go that far. So one thing I have to do is take that bolt out, and then what I do is I clamp this bolt down as tight as I can get it so that this holds. And then the fence here, it's got also a slotted bolt, but I can't get over here to 55, so what I've done is cut myself a block of wood on about a 10 or 15 degree angle, and that slots in here like this, gives me a little more angle on the movable jaw right there. I went and notched this fixed fence out right here, but you can see right down here, I had to clear all that out to let the saw come down all the way. These are what we call our motor mount spacers. These are for Toyota pickups, 4Runners, Tacomas. And what that does is you can bolt this on the frame, and then you bolt your motor mount up here. And what it does is it raises the whole engine up. This one's a 2.5 inch lift, and the motor mount brackets are at a 48 or 55 degree angle. This what raises these mounting holes, in this case 2.5 inches, lets you lift your engine and transmission up, which gives you more ground clearance if you go off-road. So let's see what that looks like here. Let's see, I think we're all set. Yeah. And there we go, one 55 degree angle cut there. Like this one's supposed to be 2.5 inches, and you can see right there it only measures 1.75. But the key is you have to measure it at that angle between the bolts, and there you can see we've got 2.5 from the top to the bottom. Yeah, you can just barely see the shadow line of the saw blade right there. And that's what I can use to set the height. I can put a mark on the tube and then just slide it in until the shadow line falls over the mark, and then I know I have my length, because I need to measure from this edge right here over to where the next piece of the cut will be. So it's really hard to measure that. Yeah, that's where the shadow line really helps for setting up these cuts. So I'm getting ready to do the next cut. Yeah, I just wanted to show you that acute angle cutting setup that I use. And that really helps make repeatable angle cuts, and you get nice square cuts because everything's anchored down. Yeah, there we go. We got the spacer pieces cut, and I have the plates cut. So now just time to weld them back together. So I thought I'd show you the finished cut there.